I am Dr. Swarchala, Scientific Director with Ziva Fertility Centers. What is egg freezing and when do we consider it as a protocol? Egg freezing is a method of preserving a woman's eggs, and it is done potentially to use them in the future for assisted reproductive technologies. These technologies include in vitro fertilization. This can be a valuable option for women who wish to delay childbearing for personal, professional, or even medical reasons. So what exactly is egg freezing? Egg freezing is also called as oocyte freezing. Oocyte is an egg, and it involves retrieving a woman's eggs, freezing them unfertilized, and storing them for later use. When the woman decides to conceive, the eggs can be thawed, that is unfrozen, fertilized with sperms in her IVF lab, and then implanted in her uterus. So this is the procedure of egg freezing. Who should consider oocyte freezing? Well, those who are considering it for personal or professional reasons. Women who wish to delay childbearing for career, education, or personal reasons can consider this. There are medical reasons also. Women undergoing treatment that may affect their fertility, such as chemotherapy or cancer, may also consider this. Women with conditions like endometriosis that can impact egg quality and quantity over time can also think about freezing their eggs. Then age-related fertility decline is also one of the factors. Women who are concerned about the natural decline in fertility that comes with aging, typically after 35, should consider oocyte freezing or egg freezing. So let's look at the oocyte freezing process. There is an initial consultation, a consultation with a fertility specialist to discuss medical history, reasons for freezing, and the process. Then comes ovarian stimulation. Hormonal medications are used to stimulate your ovaries to produce multiple eggs. This typically involves daily injections over 10 to 14 days. Then there is monitoring, regular ultrasounds and blood tests to monitor the growth and development of ovarian follicles. That's where the egg grows is also a very important step, the ultrasound monitoring. Then comes the procedure of egg retrieval, a minor surgical procedure performed under sedation to retrieve the mature eggs from the ovaries is performed. A needle is inserted through the vaginal wall into the ovaries, into the follicles under ultrasound guidance to collect the eggs. Ultimately, after this comes freezing. It is also called as vitrification. The retrieved eggs are rapidly frozen using a technique called vitrification, which prevents ice crystal formation and increases the survival rate of eggs. The frozen eggs are stored in liquid nitrogen at extremely low temperatures until the woman is ready to use them. There are a number of benefits of egg freezing, such as preservation of fertility that allows women to preserve their fertility at a younger age when egg quality is generally high. Then there is the advantage of flexibility. Egg freezing provides more control over the timing of pregnancy, offering flexibility for personal and professional planning. There is medical safety also to consider, because it provides an option for women at risk of losing fertility due to medical treatments or conditions. There are some risks and considerations. Success rate is something that has to be talked about. While egg freezing technology has improved, not all frozen eggs will survive after, you know, thawing process. They not all will fertilize successfully or lead to a healthy pregnancy. Success rate depends on the woman's age at the time of freezing and the number of eggs retrieved. Hyperstimulation syndrome is also a possible side effect of ovarian stimulation, where the ovaries become swollen and painful. This situation or condition is usually mild, but it can be severe in rare cases. There are financial conditions also that need to be discussed. Oocyte freezing can be expensive, with costs including medications, egg retrieval procedure and storage fees, etc. So how can they be used in future? When ready to use, the eggs are removed from their frozen state, which is called as thawing or warming in a laboratory. Not all eggs may survive, like I said, but these eggs are taken up for fertilization with intracytoplasmic sperm injection, where sperm is inserted into the egg. The embryo is then observed for development, and then an embryo transfer can be taken place. That is, when the endometrium is ready, one or more healthy embryos are transferred into the woman's uterus, where they may implant and lead to pregnancy. So this is the oocyte or egg freezing procedure, and who should be considering this as a treatment option. If you wish to know more about this, please feel free to contact us. Thank you. A lot of effort has gone into making this video. Please like and subscribe us. Thank you.